Hello, I'm back. I played the battle again. The army fled again, but this time the infantry was actually hunted down by our troops and they managed to rout and break and kill most of the infantry. The tanks fled. So we killed 481 instead of 300 something, like in the last battle, which was the same battle. Anyway, let's hope it doesn't crash this time. Also, the detail screen is here for anyone who is interested, and continue. Defend Paris to the last, destroy all bridges over the Seine and devastate, the city. It'll fail in August 1944. That command wasn't followed. The German general in Paris, or commander in Paris, he didn't follow Hitler's order, because he probably knew that that would mean death for him. I don't remember his fate, maybe he was killed anyway. But I guess he didn't listen to Hitler because he thought that would benefit his own case after the war. Because the war was lost, so he thought about himself. But I'm not sure he survived. He might have been executed anyway. So he might not have been rewarded for not destroying Paris. I don't know. Another Soviet force there. Let's move this army back towards Smolensk. We have two generals here. Let's move that general into the army then. So we won that battle, but we have a lot of armies there. That would be interesting. This was a large town, yes. This is just a town. Another city here, held by the Italians. We have some troops that we can move. Some BMW motorcycles will be moved towards the front there. Four infantry units in Belgrade, four in Zagreb. That sucked. Let's move the mortar to Vienna. Actually, we could use a general. Can't move Hitler, he's stuck in Berlin. But we can move Ewald Donitz. Let's move him back to Berlin for now. All right. Next turn. Civil revolt in Smolensk. So we have a revolt in Smolensk going on here. They actually took the city, the rebels. Some infantry, based on our infantry. And some British assault riflemen. All right. Our army needs to focus on the Soviet advance. So here was an important battle that we won, yeah. Don't care about Smolensk. Let the Soviets take care of the rebels. They have enough armies to do that. Oh, they have quite a force here. And the General Alexander Ivanov. Lots of T-34 tanks. Here they have a real army. The MS-1 light tanks equal to our Panzer I's. Have some infantry riflemen. Have some planes even. Yak-9s. Their worst type of fighter plane. They have two. They don't have any bombers. More Soviet armies here. Yeah. face. So... more tanks. There's some planes here. MS-1. Troops down there. He'll try to stop him. We have another great force that could move towards that army, I believe. We need to protect Minsk, the capital of Belarus. One unit will be moved out like that. So we'll have two, maybe three great battles now. We have the MCs here too. Let's move them too. Do we have any free room in this army? I don't think so. No free room. Let's move this army to one of the cities. Ah, so we have a general there. Let's move this unit back to Brest then. To Brest! Could use a mechanized unit in the city. Construction complete. In Tunis we have a cobblestone road. In we have a candidate for adoption, of course. And the turn report, we are -4061, so it's looking much better compared to before. Adoption not complete. The civil revolt in Smolensk, yes. So this Eastern Front is getting very dangerous. We have the Battle of Tobruk to fight as well. We'll send in some infantry too. They're going back later anyway. Let's send in everything. So, this army will move closer to the American front. Here we have the American army under George Patton. Full army. They seem to be a little superior to our force here. Alright. We will attack them with anything we have. We needed to leave a few riflemen in Tunis. Alright. Time to recruit some troops, maybe. This general should be moved to Vienna. And let's take a look at the construction. We're gonna finish the roads and farms of any city first. But not Tunis, it's outside of Germany. Alright. Nothing to build in the first few cities. I've already built what I wanted there. In Kyiv, we could build some farms. I believe the roads there might not have been very developed, so we won't build any roads with this code. Instead we will Let that be. Minsk, the same thing is true there. Oops, I managed to click that. So we want the farms, they increase food production. Even in Heracleion, I believe there should be such a thing. And in Brest, of course. And Riga. Belgrade. Yeah, I think so. And Athens, of course. And we're almost out of money this time too. We have war, so yeah, they could use a few farms. What? For now, we have spent our money, I believe. Alright, we're done. Only farms this time as well. The war is still far from our borders. Fleet will have to head back towards the Soviet fleet. Well, this fleet could actually move towards the British fleet. Let's save first so we don't have some issues in case I haven't solved it. Yeah, it worked. Did we lose? Impossible. We lost. Against their fleet here. It wasn't even their strongest fleet, it was their second strongest. Alright, that's not good. This fleet will still win against the Soviet. We will have control over the Baltic Sea here. But we have lost the battle here and are very vulnerable. We have the U-boats here too. We will continue hunting for Americans there. Which army? Allied army. Side of our territory. Family member. Lambic Tomasio. Lambic Tomasio, armored officer's car. They are going to attack me, they will regret that. Time to fight some battles here against the Soviets, I see. Can begin with the battle here. Care about the prospects of winning. If we lose, we will lose. They seem to have the upper hand. See their arm again. Yeah, they have at least two riflemen bodyguards, and then they have starting armies there, and then this army is a real army, not one of the starting armies. Alright. They have twice as many armies. We will still fight this battle. Fight the battle on the battle map! Come on, soldiers of the Reich! You can win. In the burning and devastated cities, we daily experience the direct impact of war. It spurred us to do our utmost. The bombing and the hardships that resulted from them did not weaken the morale of the populace. It is right to learn, even from the enemy. Albert Speer, chief of the German war economy. Speaking of the war. So the cities didn't cause the Germans to give up. It just spurred them to fight harder. Alright. The bombing of the cities. Alright, start deployment. So, loose formation, start the battle. You will just need to suicide against these Soviet riflemen. Look at their army. That's a small force. Their second army with Jack 9 fighter planes. First Soviet army with planes that we are fighting. Here we have their worst kind of tank. The worst type. The MS-1. MS-1 tank, alright. Look at this. Our poor infantry is crushed here. And there they broke. Our huge army is now entering here. Panzer Force. SS BMW motorcycles, Panzer 1s, riflemen, snipers, Stukas, strategic bombers. We even have a Vesp artillery, mobile artillery unit here. Really powerful artillery. First one we see yet. We have two generals, I believe. With jeeps as bodyguard. Yeah, two generals with jeeps. This time the Soviet Union won't retreat. Because they have the numerical advantage. Look at the tank numbers. The armies are almost stretching the entire battlefield here. Cool. Alright. And the battle will soon start. We just need to get closer to each other. Our retreating infantry is coming here. Only 18 left. Forward. Alright. So the planes have started to fight here. Our Stuka bombers are bombing their tanks. But might be shot down by their fighter planes. As you see, they are dropping bombs. The bombs are hitting forward. We took down one of the planes. And another one. Jeeps here with machine guns firing against tanks. What are the rest of the army doing? Some jeeps moving forward in slow motion there. They're like walking, not really driving full speed ahead. Alright. We didn't have any fighter planes in this part. There we have some fighter planes. Good. Are they fighting the air fighter planes? I wonder. Where are the air fighters? So we have our Messerschmitt 109 down there. They have some planes over here. Their Yak 9s are not fighting our planes currently. Armies are still to face each other. Only some small skirmishes have started. I believe the first army of Soviets have started to fight against our army. The one that was just starting armies with T-34s and Reich. They took down one of our fighters, and another one went down. That's not good, because we still need to take down their fighters. Alright, so their army is soon to face off against our army. Both armies are moving closer to each other. Our Vesp artillery is like our trump card in this battle. We can hit from a very far distance. What is the stats? 27, 50 Vesp buildings and 27 versus troops. But only 5 total defense. Alright. Our unit of riflemen have already left the battlefield. Only 18 men were remaining. So our Vesp artillery will start a fire now. To fire this artillery. Shit, their tanks have already gone through our infantry here. Our infantry lines are already broken. We have some snipers here laying on the ground firing. Will they be driven over by their tanks? Possibly. Had a lot of tanks. We had quite a few actually. Mostly infantry in this army. SVG has already been abandoned. How is the battle going over here? They have planes. Not all of them are broken yet. Their army is huge. They have two full armies here. Seems I over underestimated my army's capabilities here. Capabilities. They're crushed. If the 8% allies killed, 10% enemies killed, yeah. Maybe I should have retreated. I will retreat if they have this advantage in another battle. Seems we can't win against two armies. Not even with planes. Our poor infantry troops getting all driven over. Panzer 4 has gotten stuck there, glitched. So their tanks have reached the border, trying to hunt our infantry that managed to leave the battlefield. The battle is over. Great victory for them. So we only killed 144, they killed 576 and 140, right. Here's the detailed status deck. This battle didn't go well for the Reich. I would say to the house, as I said to those who have joined this government, I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears and sweat. Winston Churchill, 13th May 1940. Army was defeated in the east. Only have one rifleman unit left. Here we had another force. So most infantry managed to survive and a few tanks. And the Vespa artillery and some BMVs, alright. Don't think we need those. Two units is worthless, so. Alright, 18 riflemen, that's worthless as well. 24 snipers could be okay. One Waffen SS is worthless. The rest we will keep. 17 riflemen, we don't need that. This band. We lost some heroes, Friedrich Horn. We lost Hans Goebbels, the two new generals that we earned after winning previously. And we lost one real general. I believe it was Klug, Gunter von Klug. Alright. We have another battle to fight here. In the east. Shouldn't underestimate the enemy. We will still attack with this army and nothing more. Save before the battle! And what do they have? Just some starting forces. They had a unique army here, but not the full army. They had some scouts, snipers, assault infantry, riflemen, T-34s, Jack 9 planes, and MS-1. Only the Jack 9 planes are dangerous there. We have a full mechanized army here. fully mechanized army. We will win. In spite of intense efforts, the moment has drawn near when this front, already so heavily strained, will break. I consider it my duty to bring these conclusions to you, to your notice, my Führer. Field Marshal Gunther von Klug, Commander-in-Chief, Wiest, July 1944. That's the Field Marshal that we just lost. Gunther von Klug. Start deployment. So we only have 13 riflemen here. Alright, start the battle.
Der Feind hat mehr Männer geholt! Gut, so können wir mehr von ihnen töten!
Let's move the infantry towards the army. Yeah, reinforcements are arriving here. We lag as long as they are about to enter, sometimes that's the case. We'll stop when they have entered the battlefield. This army is better than the other. They have some U-88 heavy bombers. They have Messerschmitt 109 fighters. And they have lots of mechanized troops. Lots of planes, lots of tanks, lots of artillery and motorcycles and jeeps. Only one infantry unit and it's a sniper unit. The best one. The bombs are away. Our Stuka strategic bombers are dropping bombs on their troops here. No, they took down one of our Stukas. So their second army, the smaller one, is under attack here. Mostly infantry too. Even a tiger general here. General's bodyguard. Tiger 1, general's bodyguard. Yeah, lots of fighter planes too. Short work of their infantry there. They had some fighter planes as well, but they don't have the numerical advantage. And their fighter planes are a little worse than ours. They won't win this. It's a dogfight here between the fighter planes of the Soviet Union and the fighter planes of the Wehrmacht. So the full army has entered the battlefield. Let's zoom in on the mini-map so we can see more clearly what's going on here. So their army haven't really entered yet. We have some T-34 tanks. Forward, the infantry in the back. Dogfight going on in the middle of the battlefield. Panzer IVs have started to fire on their tanks. Panzer I is closing in on them as well.
Ein Feind des Reiches liegt tot zu unseren Füßen.
Tanks moving in. battle was kinda interesting to watch, but we had the upper hand here. So I would be very surprised if we wouldn't win this battle. They had too many infantry units. I like how the dogfights work in this game, too. And the tanks versus tanks. Tigers have started to fire on their tanks there. Here comes the Panzer Ones. Some tanks without turrets, Panzer Fours. Their turrets have been shot. They lost them somehow. SS infantry firing their assault rifles. It looks so bad when they don't have their turrets. But I believe it's like when a rider of an elephant falls off. That the turrets have somehow fallen off the tanks after damage. They can still fire, which is kind of good. That made that unit almost worthless. I think they could still fire, but I'm not sure. Doesn't look good when they are like that too. This infantry is heavily bombarded from the air here. Our U-88 bombers, heavy bombers, bombing their infantry. No, they took down one of our heavy bombers. Alright, let's see the statistics. Look at the statistics. 22% allies killed, 67% enemies killed, alright. Our Tiger Ones are doing a good job. They are the bodyguards. Stupid Panzer Force, all broken. All the SS infantry are marching forward here. Soviet Union still have a lot of infantry standing. We will continue. Kill as many of them as possible. Good job, planes. Boom the shit out of them. So they don't regroup later. They have too many armies already. It's a high risk that we won't stand a chance in them. Especially if our allies will betray us as well. Bombed as they run away, trying to leave the battlefield. There's their general, by the way. One of their generals. I wonder if he died here. Yeah, he died. Enemy general fallen. Nikita Ivanov just died. Look at the battlefield. A lot of carcasses and dead infantry. And the battle is over! And we won! So we killed 595 and they killed only 65 and 28 respectively. Here's the detailed statistics. Alright, we're done here. France has lost a battle, but France has not lost the war. Leader of the Free French, Charles de Gaulle, in the appeal of 18th June 1940. So we have one more battle to fight in Europe. Outside of Brest, I believe, or if it was Kiev. And then we have a battle in Africa, the Battle of Tobruk under against the Free French. Man of the Hour, because we won. If we win a battle and have a unit without a general, then we always get a new general. So we had another army down here. We will move immediately against that army. So the mechanized army still lost a lot of troops there. Send the better infantry to the army as well. Need the reinforcements there. Could also use this unit. The front. Let's see, we have 4 free slots. Could send 3 more units. We send the good infantry here, including the snipers. And we had another battle here against Alexander Ivanov. We had quite the force here. So let's save. Now we are ready to fight the battle. The heavy casualties inflicted on the enemy. The heavy casualties inflicted on the enemy have greatly affected his morale and will prove to be a turning point in the Battle of the Atlantic. Admiral Sir Max Wharton, May 1943, commander of the Eastern Approaches. Start deployment, loose formation, and start the battle. Let's move back towards the army as usual. Fuck, I managed to click. So reinforcement, yes. The army is arriving here. Lots of Stuka bombers. Also some Messerschmitts as expected here. Our Panzer IVs and Panzer I's and BMW motorcycles. I've had lots of planes. And Panzer IVs this time. But we aren't bugged. Panzer I's. More Panzer I's. Interesting. They have lots of infantry. Fortunately for them, they have also have T-34s, 5 units of them. And at least one MS-1, I believe. Yeah. They didn't have any planes, I think. All right, let's speed this up. the planes have already reached the enemy, but everyone else is coming far behind. We need to speed up to let the armies reach each other. So where are their armies? They are only on this side. Only one enemy army this time. I believe the planes have taken out a lot of their troops already. Both tanks and the infantry. The army is still far from reaching their army. Maybe they will run away from the battle. They have already lost a lot. Especially a lot of their infantry, but also tanks. They are moving. Are they running away? Are they retreating from the battle? Yeah, they are. They didn't want to face the entire army. So we won because they routed. Or they retreated. They strategically chose to leave the battlefield. To fight another day. I have some anti-air guys there too. Anti-tank guns. Continue battle.
Zeit, den Angriff voranzutreiben. Das Reich hat seine Überlegenheit durch diesen Sieg bestätigt.
Great victory, this one. I wish they didn't retreat. All right. Peace in our time. Neville Chamberlain. Speech at Heston Airport. 13th September 1938. He's in our time, yeah. All right, a new general. We lost a lot of troops there. Don't need two generals there. All the elite troops will be moved out. We have won that battle, but they have more troops to send our way. We lost a lot of our mechanized stuff there. Right. We only have Tobruk then. Tobruk. South. So the French army inside of Tobruk, they have 6 units of riflemen. They do have helmets, but not on the old pictures. They have 1 unit of snipers. And they have 1 unit of assault infantry. Then they have 1 Renault FT tank, one of the worst tanks in the game. And then because it's from World War One, and then we have anti-aircraft truck. It's pretty good actually. They might win. We'll see. If they win, it's thanks to that anti-aircraft truck. So let's play fight the battle of the battle. They have a town, I believe. Sure, we want to go home. We want this war over with. The quickest way to get it over with is to get the bastards who started it. The quicker they are whipped, the quicker we can go home. The shortest way home is through Berlin and Tokyo. And when we get to Berlin, I am personally going to shoot that paper-hanging son of a bitch Hitler, just like I'd shoot a snake. You know, Joshua's pattern, addressing to his troops before Operation Overlord, 5th June 1944. Alright, start deployment. We don't need a ram, actually. We only needed it to be able to start the battle, but we don't need it to actually enter the city or the town. They have the Siegfried line defenses, the best defenses, but they are not as effective as the other defense, because you can just move in. Even though these towers are the best, they will kill a lot of troops. But yeah, it's easier to enter the city with these defenses because there are big holes in the wall. We have our army here on the other side. Pack fort artillery ready to level their houses. Same with the mortars here, the Stokes mortar artillery. We have some Panzer IVs, some Panzer Ones. We have ordinary infantry of all types and BMW motorcycles. I believe I have a Tiger bodyguard for Erwin Rommel as well. But he is in my army. Just yeah, we have a Tiger bodyguard. And we have some snipers there. Alright, start the battle. I believe the snipers will lay down soon on the ground and start the fire. They have very long reach. So the French defenders standing here all around the town. Our army is already re-entering the city. Infantry here, and other infantry. We're running out FTs. We're also staging to fire on our troops. In the center, they have the anti-aircraft trucks. They can also attack tanks. Even though they are firing in the air, their projectiles can fire straight forward. Shit, one of our tanks are already broken. Those anti-aircraft trucks are probably overpowered. That's why I'm slightly worried we will lose. They need to be overpowered to handle the planes. That's bad news for the tanks, unfortunately. The French infantry have helmets, just not on the picture. Panzer Ones here. Panzer IVs. This is a vanilla room barrack building. I believe the Eggbacks will need to place all these unique buildings like governor's house and barracks, etc., in order to remove all the old building. Otherwise they will still have a few old buildings in all cities. The only way around that is to make them custom as well. What does the statistics look like? Allies killed 20%, enemies killed 40%, so it looks quite good, actually. It looked quite well. And our troops are entering our infantry. I sent extra infantry here, because I was afraid we would lose. I played this battle 2 times before, not in this let's play, but when I tried it and I won the first time, then I lost the second time. And I didn't want to lose this time, so I sent some extra stuff. Our assault infantry have reached, firing their assault rifles. Like how they fire. Look cool when they do. So our infantry have reached this deep into the city. Walking carefully there. So the soldiers of the Reich are about to fight over the plaza. Where the French stationed their infantry. All their trucks seem to be defeated. Seem to be dead already. Which is good news. We still have a few tanks. Seems to be more of a battle between infantry in the end. Some of our Panzer I's still here too. Yeah, they will be defeated this time. Because all their Panzers, I mean tanks, have been killed, and their anti-aircraft trucks. Barracks were destroyed. Maybe they will take out a few of the houses as well. 18% damage there. French defenders are still firing desperately at our tanks and troops. We have also the infantry here. No, they took out our Panzer I there. We may only have one left now, or two. Two left. Maybe three, actually. Good. Still haven't taken out their sander yet. The 9% of the house has been damaged. Alright. May be able to destroy that house. 1% of the other house there. 68%. Wonder who they are firing at. That house be destroyed. 86%. The defenders are here. has been destroyed. They even have a tank here, written out the FT tank. Seems artillery may have lost their ammunition or something. They might have no ammunition left. Still have a Panzer IV here. Fuck, are you routing? Soldiers! Don't run! Take the city! Alright, our infantry are retreating actually. They did have a tank left. Their forces in this area of the city are just comprised of infantry. Our Panzer IV is still firing. We're so close to take down that city. Seems they retreated. Our ammunition didn't last. What I should do is I should probably build up an entire army of artillery just to be able to level cities. Because unfortunately tanks and planes can't do it. Because you need to count as, the unit need to count as artillery in order to be able to fire on buildings. The Vesp artillery is better than these. The mortar here is the worst, and then the Pack 40 is the number 2 worst. So the riflemen are retreating. Our snipers here are still firing, so they did do their part from a safe distance. Let's see how their bullets go. I have zoomed in on the unit now. Let's see. We can't fail to hit. Here is a ram, by the way. Pretty cool. Not as obvious that there are no driver there. I don't want to risk losing room. And it's kind of suicide to move against these towers. So I guess I will just retreat with Roma. So the road here is a dirt road. Last time I played this battle and it didn't go too well, I sent in Rommel's Tiger tanks and they were all killed by the towers. So. Enemy General fallen, Captain Fontaine or whatever. I will still retreat Rommel. He is needed later in the war, I can't have him die. He's too good to die. Don't have a lot of Tiger 1 tanks, only some generals had them as bodyguard now. Rommel is safe. sabers are still firing. 24 snipers here, laying on the ground firing. Lot of dead French troops here. Lot of tank carcasses here. Our troops were taken out before they even reached the city, so their defenses are pretty strong. Took out some of the tanks before they even entered. Mostly Panzer IVs. Let's fast forward, I don't have time to wait. So we've lost 38%, they've lost 84%. Still think they will win this. Cool town. And one unit is routed there. Our snipers are still killing them one by one. Another unit routed. 38% allies killed or fled. 89% enemies killed. Their benefit is that they have the city or town, so we need to kill all of them to win. Or take the plaza, while they only need to scare away our troops. Fun being shot at from our snipers. Yeah, the snipers are still firing. They will probably not have endless ammunition. So we'll see who wins. Will our snipers be able to take down every single one of them, or will they have no ammunition left? I think we just got the answer to that question. Our snipers have no ammunition left, they can't continue. So this is a sniper unit. It's time to... No, they had ammunition still. So continue to fire. Actually, I will make it easier. And they are shot down from afar. Helpless. Now they have no ammunition left. How many do they have lost now? They lost 95% and we lost 38%. Alright, we have no ammunition left now. So, time to run. Pistols for their melee fighting, but all the infantry probably have pistols. I don't want my snipers to be wasted in a pistol fight. So it's better to retreat them. We can use them later as snipers to defend Benghazi or something. So we lost the battle. We killed 95% of their troops. So. But we also have the United States and the British and more French areas to fight in Africa. We are at a real disadvantage. And the army has left. And the snipers are secure. Only the artillery left, controlled by our ally. But they decided to flee. Smart move. I was afraid they would just stand there forever. They decided to retreat as well, which is good. So 24 in both units, probably full units. 24 soldiers in each. And we had to retreat from the town. Close defeat. Men deployed 63, killed 279. That was very good, thanks to our snipers. Our Tiger 1 tanks didn't do anything. But leaving the battlefield. Captain Joseph, 525 men, killed 279. That wasn't as good. And they killed 222 and had 587. Good, it didn't crash. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender. Conquered, we conquer. Prime Minister Winston Churchill. Oh, all right. And we managed to exit without the crash. Good. Not a lot survived that battle. Erwin Rommel himself survived. The artillery survived intact. One full unit of riflemen. Don't need one unit of assault rifle. The infantry, so we will remove them. Alright, we have artillery and infantry left. And one Tiger tank bodyguard. Doesn't look too good. Would we suicide attack the United States there? Let's click next town. So the Soviets are attacking Kyiv, or besieging Kyiv. Another general is very much needed. Let's move him from Berlin down to München. Settlement besiege Kyiv by the Soviet Union. We have Walter Busch there, family member. Alright, they have Rebel Ivanov with a starting army there, 5 T-34 tanks. We will send this army against the Soviet army there. Forward soldiers, never surrender. So we have another army to fight here. They have a real army here. T-34 tanks, Yak-9 planes, even MS-1 tanks, and lots of infantry of all kinds. Italy is still holding Kharkov. And the MC gang took together with these infantry units will aid Kiev. They already have lots of infantry. Now they get at least a BMW motorcycle, and they have a bodyguard of Yeeps too. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. India have declared war on Portugal. So two neutral factions. The following factions have declared that they are allies. India isn't neutral, they are allied to the British. And at war with the Japanese, I believe. The following factions have declared that they are allies. Romania and Hungary, yeah, they should be allies. They had probably broken their alliances before. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. Romania and the USSR. That isn't supposed to happen. Even though it is supposed to happen in 1943, I believe, and Romania decided to betray Germany for the USSR. It happened earlier this time. Their ceasefire with the Union. All right, and we are no longer minus in income. That's good. Settlement besiege Kiev, the USSR. I know that. Now let's see Benghazi. Is it also under siege? No, but it's revolting. We're moving troops there. I don't need two units of riflemen. Disband. Oh, the United States of America have conquered Alger from the Vichy regime of France. They have full army, including Shermans there. M4 Shermans. You're too weak to fight them. Move back to Tunis. The army here. The Portuguese, are they going to attack us? Family member, David de Mello. What do we have? Few troops. Mostly infantry. I don't fear that army too. They have one army here ready to fight. We won't start this battle, we will let them attack the city. A general with infantry there. Minsk. Let's move back towards Riga with that force. Riga is a large town. Right. This army here. We might actually attack these two armies, starting armies. We have three interesting battles here. They also have an army here that might actually take a shortcut and attack us. It's not Stalin, but it's a general with Stalin's portrait. Leonid Petrov. Alright. Because Stalin can't move from Moscow. Is this Moscow then? Nah, that's Smolensk. Alright. Our fleets are about to fight the air fleet there. I want to save just to be secure. Does this their fleet? Orlans. Similar to our Hermelines, and then they have troopers. I don't think There they are. The British, they have a huge fleet there. And our U-boat fleet, what is it up to? No enemy ships in sight. They are terrorizing the Atlantic. Alright. We have the Vichy fleet blockading the port at Alger. They have a huge fleet, including Dunkirk ships, Richelieu ships. Alright. The Vichy are taking revenge on the Americans by blockading their port with their one great remaining powerhouse, their fleet. So the Eastern Front is taking place in the Ukraine currently. It's not too far away into the Baltic and into Poland, and then they will be in our lands. Bulgarian army here, probably waiting to an opportunity to betray us. Alright, let's construct some buildings again. Tunis. Amsterdam, Brussels, Paris, Rouen, Bordeaux, Kiev. They didn't have roads. Minsk. Alright. At least I don't think roads were necessarily evolved here. In Athens we could make some farms. And I believe in Athens they had roads as well. We'll give them modern roads. Seems to be a glitch. You can see the roads now, but if I move closer, it kind of disappears. You can still see the trucks. Weird. That's probably a glitch or something. If I move, that happens. Can't get too close, I guess. Right. Belgrade. I don't know about that. Warsaw, yeah, they had roads. But I don't know if they had asphalt roads. They had cobblestone roads, for sure. Benghazi, no, don't think so. Zagreb, yeah, they could have had some farms. Vienna, of course, had farms. Prague. Czechoslovakia or something. I think they had both roads and farms. too close to Germany not to have it. Stettin is a German city, so of course they had farms. Copenhagen, of course, the Danish capital, they had farms. Berlin, so we're back at Berlin, alright. Then we're done. Now it's time to build and recruit stuff without using that command. Good. As you can see on the map, the roads are more evolved now. In most of the areas anyway. I believe in Czechoslovakia they should have modern roads. You couldn't build anything better there. So, looking much better. As for the roads. Cool with the trucks moving around. Farms plus one, farm plus two. Cobblestone road. Asphalt road. Now let's take a look at what we can build. Believe in Berlin. Civil headquarters. Small park. I believe we will build a port in Berlin. Tunis, we could actually build farms. München, we could build a small park. We don't have a lot more to build. We don't have a lot of money. In Frankfurt, we can upgrade the walls, the sandbag wall. We will do that. We only had a city without any wall. Now we will add the sandbag wall there. And we can't build anything more, alright. We can recruit some troops. Let's go back to Berlin. We have the biggest roster we can recruit from there. Alright, I want a diplomat. So we can't recruit anything else there then. In Tunis I do want some North Africa assault corps. They are just SL Rifleman, but Africa textured 3757 5738, so these are slightly better. That's good. Unique for the African theater. If we take areas in the Middle East, we might get Islamic troops as well, Arabs. Alright, we can't do much more this turn. We have some battles to fight. Let's start with this battle. What? They have full army here. We had quite a force there as well. I don't care about the statistics. We will try to fight the battle. Even if every unit is destroyed. Let's start the battle. No, it crashed. I will try again later. See ya.